Know how to handle your HTTP headers is very important when you are developing one web application. Because with headers, we can customize the behavior, we can customize the security, and implementing several requirements of our software. So having using frameworks such as Spring Boot, we can customize in a very fine level the fields that we are going to write in the HTTP response packages. So in this video, we are going to see how to perform this customization. So let's take a look in the code first. Basically, we are going to use this response entity class, which is a native class from your application, your Spring Boot application. And then when we are going to instantiate one object from this class, we are going to inform three parameters. First, the code of the response. So here you can see that this enum variable HTTP status has a great amount of possible codes to return to your client, okay? And then we have in the first parameter the object we are going to return to the client as a response. So it's very nice because it receives one object as the response, so it can handle how this response will be delivered, if a list as a JSON, if one single variable or as a string, any object could be delivered as the object to be the returned value. But the second parameter is the goal of this video, is an object from the HTTP headers class. And here we can set like a map, k and value variable, a lot of fields we want in the header. So how many fields you want to set. In this example, we have here fields necessary to handle the course issue when some JavaScript program is consuming the service. And here, just one example, how to, for instance, write a cookie in the client browser. So let's take a look in this execution. First of all, it's just a private method that the idea is to be generic and can be reutilized in several methods. So the service itself is here, flagged with request mapping. And then it's retrieving to the client one response entity object. And then it's, in this case, use one repository to give us, here's the example, we use the repository to give us one list, for instance, one list of actors object, and then we set that to be built in the response package. So we call the method we have just seen, and then it is going to set the fields to handle cores and to handle the cookie. Now we are going to run this service. We stop that, we run our project, okay? And now when we call this endpoint here, so basically it's here, I'm going to refresh that. Let's take a look in the network tab. Let's clear that and call again. And then here we are going to see what has come with this request. It has given to us, okay, it's already in the maximum size. Look, we have here the response headers. Here we have exactly the fields we have set in that code. For instance, we supported the post, get, options, and delete method, not any other, no put, for instance. And then any origin with this star. And then we have here the set cookie example that will create actually a cookie here. If you open the application tab, you can see here in the cookies list that we have a cookie variable created. So just to make another demonstration, if you come here and change that we are going to support the put verb as well, so we can just restart our service using Maven build. And now it's going to reload our service in the port. Just wait a little bit. Okay, it's running. And then now if we call again, let me just open here the console tab, the network tab, and clear the output to to not be mixed with the old one. Okay, it was processed. And look here, now put is available as one of the allow methods. But what's the nice from this method? That actually any kind of headers field you want to customize, you have the possibility without first have to use some very specific method of the specific framework. So that's for this video. You can take a look at this search code, the link available in the video description. Thank you for watching.